Adding a video watermark is a critical skill so you can protect your creative work. I use a great service called VideoBlocks for building many of my new tutorials, and I decided to give them a quick plug in doing this tutorial. To create a video watermark, ideally you want a high-resolution image file on a transparent background. Many professional software programs will show a checkerboard background, indicating that the file has a transparent area. This transparent background area is called an alpha channel. A common problem is that your customer may not be able to supply you with a file that contains an alpha channel. So, I've got a copy of Photoshop CC for Windows running here. Now, what may seem crazy the most is I'm going to launch the Safari web browser on my Mac, even though I'm running a Windows PC version of Photoshop. Within my VideoBlocks subscription, I'll find a background layer to use in this tutorial. So as this is downloading, I see they have their company logo in the upper left corner of their website. If you're running OS X on a Mac, you can use the keyboard shortcut Command-Shift-4 to take a snapshot of a specific screen area. It will place the snapshot on your desktop. Now, ideally, you want a high-resolution image on a solid color background. This logo here is fairly small, but at least it's on a solid white background. By the way, as another quick side note, I'll often use Google Images to find a higher resolution image for my customer. To do that, within Google Images, click on the Search Tools button, and then click on the pull-down menu for size, and choose Large. So you can see here, this logo is 2700 pixels by 439 pixels. To prove my point that you can still make a good-looking watermark from a smaller image, let's use the graphic that I took a snapshot of. Drag the graphic from your desktop directly into Photoshop. While in Photoshop, hold down the Alt key and roll your mouse wheel to zoom into your graphic. Navigate to the Photoshop toolbar and click and hold down the left mouse button to select the Magic Eraser tool. Use the Magic Eraser tool to click on the areas of the background you'd like to remove. You may need to click on additional areas to remove all the pieces parts of your image, for example, inside this D, E, and O. Okay, after your image is on a transparent background, navigate to the Layers window tab and double-click on the layer. Within the Layer Style dialog box, click on the Bevel and Emboss category. Make sure you click on the actual category and not just the checkbox. Adjust the size and depth of the bevel. In this case, because my graphic is so small, I'm only going to use a size of 2 pixels, but a larger depth. Navigate back to the Layers window tab and adjust the fill for the layer to 0%. Okay, that's it. Now all you need to do is save the file. I recommend that you save the file as a .png because it will embed the transparent background into the PNG image so you can use it with your favorite video editing program. So in this example, I'll just save over my original file that I had imported from the desktop. Okay, since I'm using a Mac, I also have access to Final Cut Pro 10, which I'll launch from my dock. I'm going to click on the Finder icon in the dock so I can access the Downloads folder so you can see the clip I downloaded earlier. Okay, I'll drag my background video and my music to the Final Cut Pro 10 browser window and then edit them into my project. And then finally, I'll go back to my glass watermark that I saved to the desktop and drag it straight to the Final Cut Pro 10 timeline window. And wow, there you go! As a quick side note, if you're using Final Cut Pro 10, you can use the keyboard shortcut Command-T to quickly add video dissolves on both ends of your graphic. For other great tips like this, or to enroll in a video editing training course, visit geniusdv.com.